Okay, so if you're looking for a good single turbo, you're gonna love the diesel power source S300 and S400 turbos in T3 and T4 sizes. Here's how to select a DPS turbo on our website. First, from the Select Cummins Year drop box, you select the correct year of your truck. The years go from 1988 up to 2007. These are all 5.9 Cummins years. If you have a 6.7 Cummins, which is a 2007 and a half or later, you'll need to go to our third gen swap page because you'll need a third gen swap kit, which is basically a turbo, manifold, water block offs, and some other minor parts. For all first and second gen trucks, years 1988 to 2002, you will need an HX40 downpipe to connect to the exhaust. Otherwise, these turbos are a direct bolt-on stock replacements. For third gen common rails, years 2003 through 2007, our turbos will directly bolt up to the cast iron stock exhaust elbow. Next, you select your turbo size from the drop-down box. These are categorized in stages, the smallest being stage 1, a 62-65 by 0.70 S300, which means it has a 62mm compressor wheel, a 65mm turbine wheel, a 0.70 AR housing. This is an S300 turbo. The largest S300 being a stage 9, which is a 69 by 73 by 0.80. 0.70 AR housings are also called 12cm housings. 0.80 AR housings are also commonly referred to as 14cm housings. Our stage 10 and above are S400 turbos. To understand which stage will be a good fit for you, it is helpful to refer to the Dodge Cummins Turbo Spool Up and Horsepower Comparison Guide, located in the overview below. This guide gives you a minimum and maximum horsepower ratings. While the minimum number is not that important, the maximum number is very important. You never want to select too small of a turbo for your truck. Running too small of a turbo could overspin and destroy your new turbo. So do not exceed the maximum horsepower rating. Please take into account that putting our DPS turbo on your truck will increase your horsepower by 13 to 15% of what your truck did with the stock turbo. Next is the turbine exhaust housing upgrades drop box. This is where you have the option of selecting either a normal fixed vane, which is the standard wastegated exhaust housing, or our Turbinator VGT mechanical housing, or the Turbinator electronic with exhaust brake housing. The Turbinator is a performance VGT exhaust housing that improves your spool up time by 200 to 500 RPMs, and it makes the turbo more efficient throughout the entire RPM band. The next drop box is the T3 or T4 turbo flange. Our turbos come in T3 and T4 flange sizes. Your turbo and manifold have to be the same flange size. For most applications, we recommend the T3, but whatever you select, make sure it matches your manifold. Next is the exhaust manifold drop-down box. You are not required to purchase an exhaust manifold with your turbo, but you are given the option of doing so at a discounted price while purchasing the turbo. While you have your turbo out, it may be a good idea to replace your stock manifold with one of our multi-piece high-flow performance manifolds. The next drop box is the oil drain. It is not mandatory, but many people like to replace their old oil drain when they are replacing their turbo. First and second gens use a 19-inch, and the third gens use a 12-inch. If you're getting a turbo for a compound setup, let us know so we can make sure it's clocked and it comes with the correct actuator. Hey gang, hopefully this has been helpful. Let us know in the comments below or email us if you have any more questions. And don't forget, subscribe.